Major funding for this afternoon's programming is provided by the Helena Rubinstein Foundation, a longtime supporter of outstanding children's television.
Today's Caper is presented by WQED Pittsburgh and WGBH Boston. Carmen's gang is bankrolled by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and viewers like you.
This program is brought to you by Toyota.
All these people want to know, where in the world is Carmen Sandiego?
Carmen Sandiego.
And one of these people could find her. Lindsey. Raj Woodyall. Brent Keller. Today's episode, The Case of the Roman Ruin. And this is the man in charge of training new recruits, Greg Lee.
Lindsey, how are you? All right. Hey, Brent. You guys feeling okay?
Yeah.
All right, let's try this. Here we go. Yeah. One of these days, it's going to happen, I guarantee you. Okay, you all know who this is right here. She's the chief of Acme Crime Net. Hey, chief.
Hey. Gumshoes.
Hi, chief.
Hi, Gumshoes. I hope you're ready today. Carmen's vile pack of predators have pulled off another pinch. This time, they hit Rome, Italy's ancient arena, the Coliseum. Now, the thief was that muscle-bound monster, Eartha Brute. She marched right up to the Coliseum in broad daylight, flexed her bicep, picked it up as if it were light as a feather, and walked off with it. Now, here's the poop on Eartha Brute. First, she's big. Second, she's huge. Third, she is immense. So you better outthink her because you can't overpower her. Here's your job, Gumshoes. Recover the Coliseum and track down Eartha, and then capture Carmen Sandiego. Greg?
Thanks a lot, Chief. All right, Gumshoes, we're going to start you off with 50 Acme Crime Bucks. Anytime you answer a question correctly, you get 10 more. Then the two of you that have the highest score at the end of this round will go on to the next round, okay? Now, before we go and try to find out where Eartha has gone, let's try to find out, first of all, a little bit about you. Brent, it says here that you've had some interesting adventures traveling. Is that right?
Yes. One time, we were supposed to go to Buffalo, and the flight was, like, jammed up, so they asked us if we'd wait till the next flight.
Yeah?
So, and they told us they'd give us free tickets to anywhere in the United States, so we waited and we got free tickets to California.
Wow, that's pretty great.
Yeah.
That's tremendous. Did you know anybody in California, or you just went out there
for fun? No, but it was really fun.
That's tremendous. Okay. Raj, I understand that your family is from India, and you've been to India yourself, is that right?
Yes.
Have any thoughts on that?
It's amazing because 30% of the population there is homeless, and yet my relatives have luxuries like TVs and VCRs.
Wow. I suppose they're considered pretty wealthy over there then.
I guess so.
Wow. Well, that's interesting. Lindsey, it says here that you've been to Bahamas, Mexico, Canada, Spain. Where did you enjoy yourself the most?
I think it was the Bahamas.
Why was that?
I did more stuff that I can remember because it was most recent, like snorkeling. And we saw a coral reef. A boat brought us out there. It was really great.
Really nice. Well, listen, we're all glad that you're all here on the case. It's time to get started. So, Chief, let's get started.
All right. Here's what we know so far. Eartha went to the Iberian Peninsula, and she was seen eating 20 gallons of paella at a sidewalk restaurant in the city where Rossini's opera about a barber takes place. You know, that's always been one of my favorites. Figaro! Figaro, Figaro, Figaro. I should warm up. Okay, Gumshoes, go get them.
Okay, thanks a lot, Chief. Gumshoes, to what city did Eartha take the Coliseum? Was it Barcelona, Seville, or Lisbon? Remember the clues that we heard from the Chief. Iberian Peninsula, Paella, and Rossini's opera. Lindsey, we'll start with you. What do you say?
I chose Seville.
Seville. Raj, what do you think?
I chose Barcelona.
Barcelona. Brent, what do you say?
I chose Lisbon.
Lisbon. This is interesting. The answer we're looking for, Seville. Nice job, Lindsey. Takes you up 10 points. All right. Now, Eartha left Spain before we could catch her, but one of our Acme CelebNet agents has some ideas of where she's at. Harmony?
Greetings, Gumshoes, for what it's worth. Want the 10th largest country on the planet Earth? 7 countries in North Africa lie on its borders, and still it opens up to Mediterranean waters. If you find yourself lost, just shift your gears and aim for the capital. It's known as Algiers.
Okay, thanks a lot, Harmony. Gumshoes, name the country. Is it Libya, Algeria, or Spain? Remember the things that we heard? 10th largest country, and its capital is Algiers. Everybody's ready. Lindsey, we'll start with you.
I chose Algeria.
Algeria. Raj, what do you say?
I chose Algeria.
Algeria. Brent, what do you think?
I chose Algeria.
Everybody says Algeria. Everybody's right. Nice job. Gumshoes. Okay, so that means, Lindsey, you have 70, Raj, you have 60, and Brent, you have 60. That's the way to play this game, you guys. Okay, now, our agents are headed to Morocco right now.
You might as well call them back. She's gone.
How do you know that?
You dare to question me?
No, sorry. I take it back. Go ahead.
That's better. She's in a landlocked country in southern Africa. She wanted a quick workout, so she's swimming up Victoria Falls. Later, she's going to race a few gazelles.
Oh, listen, since you're on that topic, do you have any hot tips on the stock market?
Don't press your luck, pal.
Sorry. Okay, Gumshoes, name the country. Is it Mozambique, Madagascar, or Zimbabwe? Remember the things that we heard from The Voice. Landlocked country, southern Africa, and gazelles. Lindsey's ready. Let's hear
from
you.
I chose Zimbabwe.
Zimbabwe. Raj, what do you think?
I chose Zimbabwe.
Zimbabwe. Brent, what do you think?
I chose Zimbabwe.
Zimbabwe. The answer we're looking for, Zimbabwe. Nice job, everybody. Okay, so, Lindsey, you have 80 crime bucks. Raj, you have 70. Brent, you have 70. Still very close. Well, that can only mean one thing. It's time for the lightning round. What's going to happen is I'm going to give you 3 questions. Any one of you that answers one of these questions correctly, I'll give you an extra 5 crime bucks, okay? Hands on your buzzers, if you will. Please listen very carefully. Dalmatian, Saluki, Rhodesian Ridgeback. It was first bred for hunting. Which of these standard dog breeds took its name from the country now called Zimbabwe? No answers? The answer we're looking for is Rhodesian Ridgeback. Okay, let's try another question. Listen carefully. Belgium, France, and England. Which of these nations are once claimed ownership of the nation now known as Zimbabwe? Belgium, France, or England? No guesses there either. The answer we're looking for was England. Okay, we have one more. Listen carefully. Harare, Mombasa, or Zamba? Which of these is the capital of Zimbabwe? Brent.
Harare.
Harare, right. Nice job. Okay, you get 5. So that means, Lindsey, you have 80, Raj, you have 70, and Brent, you have 75. Nice job, Gumshoes. That's the way we like to play.
Greg. Yes, my office, right away.
Oh, yes, ma'am. Be right back. We always do this during the day. Keeps us close. You guys stick around.
Greg, I am worried about the Gumshoes.
Mm-hmm,
I mean, Eartha is scary.
Well, you know.
She scares me. I don't know what to do to get them to, you know, really go, you know.
They need some incentive.
And some incentive?
Yes. I
got an idea.
Okay.
Gumshoes, listen up. Now, I want Carmen Sandiego, you know? So, I will give you a trip anywhere in the lower 48 states if you catch her. And I think that's a pretty good deal.
Hey, pretty good deal.
Yeah. Hey. No way.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Hi, Gumshoes. Everything okay?
Yeah.
All right, listen, I want to remind you, we're still looking for the Colosseum that Eartha took from Rome. Got to stay on it. Don't lose heart yet. Now, to help, Acme Bugnet has just got this recording between Eartha and crime boss Carmen Sandiego. Listen.
Carmen, they almost caught me. I had to wrestle 2 elephants and a wildebeest to create a diversion.
Cheese it, Eartha. Head for Bogota. I have a safe house near there on a coffee plantation.
Where's Bogota?
Where'd you learn geography? Bogota, smack in the middle of the northern Andes. Just tell them you're una amiga especial de Carmen.
But I have no idea what that means.
They'll know what it means. Now amscray.
All right, Gumshoes, name the country. Is it Colombia, Suriname, Bolivia? Remember the clues that we heard? Bogota, coffee plantation, and northern Andes. Lindsey, we'll start with you.
I chose Colombia.
Colombia. Raj, what do you say?
I chose Colombia.
Colombia. Brent, how about you?
I chose Colombia.
Everyone says Colombia. Everyone's right. Nice job. Colombia is the answer we're looking for. Okay, so Lindsey, you have 90. Raj, you have 80. Brent, you have 85. That's the way to play this game. Now, we have next... This is a, I guess this is a note possibly from Eartha. Let's see what this says. Short of bricks, I guess. Oh, this is to the owner of the Chargers. Listen closely. It says, I'm on my way to the southern end of California, flying into Lindbergh Field. I'll trade a used Coliseum for a job on your defensive line. Yours at large, Eartha. All right, Gumshoes, name the city. Is it San Francisco, Los Angeles, or San Diego? Remember the things that we heard from the note. Chargers, Southern California, Lindbergh Field. Brent is ready. Raj is ready. Lindsey's ready. We'll start with you, Lindsey. What do you think?
I chose San Diego.
San Diego. What do you think, Raj?
I chose San Francisco.
San Francisco. Brent, what do you say?
I chose San Diego.
San Diego. The answer we're looking for? San Diego. Nice job, Lindsey and Brent. Okay, so Lindsey, that gives you 100. Raj, 80. Brent, 95. That's the way to play this game. Okay, next, we have... Our next clue. I love those guys. All right. Name the town, Gumshoes. Is it Sioux Falls, Fargo, or Rapid City? Remember the clues that we heard from Rockapella. Near Minnesota, South Dakota, corn farming town. Everybody's ready. Lindsey, we'll start with you. What do you say?
I chose Sioux Falls.
Sioux Falls. Raj?
I chose Fargo.
Fargo. Brent, what do you think?
I chose Sioux Falls.
The answer we're looking for, Sioux Falls. Nice job, Lindsey and Brent. Okay, so Lindsey, you have 110. Raj, you have 80. Brent, you have 105. It is now time for the final clue of this round, which means you now get to decide how much you want to risk. If you're right, we'll add that amount to your score. If you're not right, we'll subtract it from your score. Now, you can risk 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, or 50 crime bucks. Now, take a look right over here. Here's a portion of the world where we think that Eartha is headed. Now, if you know a lot about this part of the world, you'll want to risk a lot. If you don't know quite so much about it, you may not want to risk quite so much. Look at this part of the world. Think about it. I think we are nearing the end. Oh, yeah, come in. Yeah.
Bizarre confectionery, Graham.
Oh, a bizarre confectionery girl. Who sent this to me?
It's from Tivoli Gardens.
Tivoli Gardens, that's great. Thank you so much. Thank you. You're great. Thank you. All right. Listen to this, you guys. Chief. Chief, I just got some Scandinavian candy here, but, you know, this isn't really my language at all.
Oh, well, Greg, it's my language. You want me to translate?
Yeah, that would be very good.
All right.
Okay, look at this. We have this one. It's called Tisablia.
Tisablia. Well, that means wet diapers, Greg.
Wet diapers?
Yeah.
Okay. Here's another one. Bremsespor.
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 Well, that translates as skid marks.
Skid marks?
Yeah.
Cool. All right. How about this one? Mohaklaga.
Oh, well, that's... that means... Seagull, you know, what comes out of a seagull.
You mean you're talking about
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Great. Really?
Who gave that to you?
I don't know. I'm not really sure. All right, Gumshoes, there you have it. It's time now to name the country. Is it Germany, Denmark, or the Netherlands? Remember the clues that we heard. Scandinavia, Tivoli Gardens, and candies. All right, Raj, you have 80 crime bucks. We're going to start with you. Before you show me your answer, how much did you risk?
I risked 50.
50, and there it is right there. That means if you're right, you will go ahead and take the lead. What's the answer?
I chose Denmark.
Denmark is exactly the answer we're looking for. Nice job, Raj. Takes you up to 130. Brent, you have 105. How much did you risk?
I risked 30.
30. That means if you're right, you will take the lead. What'd you say?
I said Denmark.
Denmark. Nice job. You're in the lead. 135 here. Lindsey, you have 110. How much did you risk?
I risked 20.
If you're right, then you will tie for second place with Raj. What do you say?
Denmark.
Denmark. Nice job. So this means this. Brent, you're definitely going on to the next round. We got to find out who's going to go with you. So Raj and Lindsey, listen very closely. We're going to try to break this tie. Here's how we're going to do it. I'm going to name a city. What you have to do is tell me what state that city is in. I'm going to keep naming cities until you, one of you gives me the correct answer. Okay? So hands on the buzzers, please. And listen very carefully. Here we go. Steamboat Springs. Telluride. Pueblo. Lindsey.
Colorado.
Colorado's right. Nice job. Lindsey and Brent, you're going on to the next round. Good job. Raj, you were a great detective. You did some great stuff for us today. We've assembled a kit that's going to help you in your next case. Chief.
It's the official Acme Crime Net travel kit. And it includes a world traveler's atlas, the official Carmen watch, a Carmen t-shirt, and a subscription to National Geographic's World Magazine. And our thanks for all your good work on this case today. Raj, I salute you.
Okay, thanks a lot, Chief. Now, Brent and Lindsey, congratulations. You got the crook. Now it's time for us to go ahead and go to Copenhagen, Denmark, and track him down. You've got to find him, bring him back. That's what you have to do. But I want you to know, we don't send our agents out into the field unprepared. Chief, how about a briefing?
All right. Now, here's the lowdown on Copenhagen. Now, it was founded over 800 years ago. Now, its biggest city is Copenhagen in Denmark. It's the home of Parliament and the Danish royal family. Now, the boys down at Acme Photo Recon have put together a few slides for you. But first, here we have New Havn, or New Harbor to you and me. Now, keep your eyes out. Eartha may try to hide the Coliseum among the boutiques and restaurants there. Next, Strøet. Now, this mile-long shopping avenue is amazing just for Eartha there. Everyone turns up there sooner or later, but cars are prohibited. Next, Tivoli Gardens, 20-acre amusement park smack in the middle of the city. I mean, these people know how to live. It was built in 1843, and it has rides, concerts, ballet, the works, and finally, the famous Little Mermaid statue. You know, when I was young, I knew a mermaid. I really did. She was my little secret sea friend called Vespa, and I would spend hours knee-deep in the surf just visiting with Vespa, but I got other friends, and Vespa stopped coming around so much. But sometimes, even today, I still take off my shoes, and I wade into the sea, and I wait for Vespa to find me. But all I get is wet feet. There you go. Eartha and the Coliseum are in lovely Copenhagen. Go get them, Gumshoes!
Okay, Gumshoes, here we are. Put on your suitcases right here. And if you'll just take your positions right over there, let me show you what we got going on. Here are the possible locations where you'll be able to find Eartha, the Coliseum, and a warrant for Eartha's arrest. Now, the first thing you have to do is find the loot. That's the evidence you need so that you can get the warrant. Once you get the warrant, then you can arrest the crook. If you connect all three of those in that order in one turn, then you get a chance to chase Carmen Sandiego. If you catch Carmen Sandiego, then you get a trip to almost anywhere in the lower 48 United States. All right? So, So, let's see. Brent, were you ahead at the end of that last round?
Yes.
I think you were. So you go first. Go ahead.
I'm going to pick the round tower.
Round tower. Nothing there. Okay. Lindsey.
I'll pick Stroget.
Stroget, yes. Nothing there. Okay. Brent?
I'll go with the stock exchange.
Stock exchange.
The loot.
Nice job. You got the loot. Now if you can find the other two.
All right. I'll go with the university.
University. Nothing there. No more free looks. Okay. Lindsey, go ahead.
Stock exchange.
Stock exchange.
Ciao.
And the Royal Museum.
And the Royal Museum. Nothing there. Okay. Brent, your turn.
All right. I'll go with stock exchange.
Stock exchange.
And
ciao.
And New Harbor.
And New Harbor.
The warrant.
You got the loot. You got the warrant. Can you find the crook?
How about Little Mermaid?
Little Mermaid.
Eartha Brute.
Yes. Yeah. Nice job. Brent, come on over here, bud. Come here. Congratulations. Nice job. So you got the crook. There's only one more thing I want you to do. Bring down this chain, if you will, please, gentlemen. And you see this right here. You caught her. Now it's time to put her in jail. If you give a pull right there and put Eartha in jail, please. Nice job. Lindsey, listen, you were a great detective. You tracked Eartha all the way here, but you're going home with something very special. Chief?
It's a pocket translator for instant translations of 14,000 words and phrases in 10 European languages. Nice work, Gumshoe.
Okay, Brent, listen. As you know, detectives always have a lot of paperwork. I want you to take this top secret document. I want you to write down where you would like to go if you catch Carmen Sandiego and get the U.S. trip. So open it up and write it down right now. Okay, we're going to keep that secret. Listen, you had a great day. You caught Eartha. You put her in jail. We got the Coliseum back to Rome. Things are working out very nicely for you. Hold on a second. Can you hold this?
Sure.
I got to get that real quick. I'm not sure where they... I'm really not sure where... Oh, here we... Oh, here it is. Okay. Hello? Hello? Yes. Yes, he's right here. Yeah, hold on one second. Yeah. Here you go. It's for you. Just talk right into that and you can listen.
Hello? Carmen double-crossed me, so I'm gonna get even. Look for her in the United States.
United States? Okay, looks like you and I are going to the United States. Chief?
Brent, here's a list of places Carmen may have traveled. Washington. Nevada. Arizona. Montana. New Mexico, Kansas, Minnesota, Wisconsin, Missouri, South Carolina, New York, Maine. Greg, take Brent to the mat!
This is it. This is what it's all about, all right? What you got to do now is track Carmen Sandiego through seven different states, identifying each state with its flag. Now, if you're right, you'll hear this sound. And if you're wrong, you'll hear this sound. Okay? Now, if you miss it twice, if you can't find her two times, just leave the flag there and go on. But if you get all seven within 45 seconds, you will then win the trip to wherever you wrote down on that piece of paper just a minute ago. Okay?
Yep.
Sound pretty good to you?
Yeah.
Sound pretty good to you guys?
Yeah!
All right. Now, listen very closely to the clues. As soon as you think you know where the state is, start running, okay?
Got it.
Okay, let's go up this way now, and we'll pick up your first flag. Let's get 45 seconds up on the clock. Good luck to you, Brent. On your mark, get set, go. Bisected by the Rio Grande. Its capital is Santa Fe. Carmen went to New Mexico. Nope, not it. That's it, okay. It's the home of over 8,500 lakes. The largest is Lake Winnebago. Carmen went to Wisconsin. 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 That's it, yeah. The nation's second most populous state. Its capital is Albany. Carmen went to New York. Yeah. Its name means snow-covered in Spanish. Its capital is Carson City. Carmen went to Nevada. You got it. Home of the Royals and the Cardinals. Its capital is Jeff City. Carmen went to Missouri. Missouri. Sorry, that's not it. That's not it. Missouri. Sorry, that's not it. What else going on? Nicknamed the Pelican. Oh, shoot. How many did you get right that time? He got four right. Come on over here. Give him a round of applause, folks. Come on down here, Brent. I'm telling you. Carmen sometimes can be pretty tough to catch, but remember, you did get Eartha, you did get the Coliseum back to Rome. You've done some good stuff. Isn't that right, Chief?
We certainly did. Now, Brent, we're all proud of the good work you did throughout the day, and we here at headquarters pitched in to purchase a portable CD player that we thought you would enjoy, and a selection of CDs from around the world.
It's not bad, right? Okay. So you got the CDs, you got the CD player. Thanks so much for being on the show. You've done a lot of stuff for us today. There's one more thing I want you to do. Let's do it. Do it, Rockapella! Okay.